We're starting with number 18 of the solutions to the practice problems for the intermediate algebra midterm 1. Solve the inequalities and write answer in interval notation. Number A. So this is a compound inequality. It says 4 is greater than 2x minus 3, which is then greater than negative 15. You could solve this all at once, or you could break it up into two statements and do and. I think it's easier to do all at once. So I'm going to try to isolate x in the middle here. So I want to add 3 to both all three parts to preserve the inequality. And that'll give you 7 is greater than 2x is greater than negative 12. And now I know what 2x is between, but I have to divide everything by 2. To solve for x. So 7 halves is greater than x is greater than negative 6. Now, when you're writing a compound inequality like that, you want to rewrite it so it has the smaller number on the left. So if 7 halves is bigger than x, which is bigger than negative 6, then that means negative 6 is smaller than x, which is less than 7 halves. Now, you could write 7 halves or 3 and a half. That doesn't matter. All right, because when to put it in interval notation, you always have to have the smallest number on the left. So, now, x is between these. They're both less than, so I'm going to use parentheses, negative 6 to 7 halves. Now, this is not, that's not an ordered pair. You have to do it, you have to know what problem you're doing in context, and this says, write the answer in interval notation. So this is what interval notation looks like when we're solving the problem. So if you just see this in isolation, something like negative 6, 7 halves, you would never know if you're looking at an ordered pair or you're looking at something in interval notation. All right, let's work on part B. So again, we need to solve for x, which is squished in between the negative 1 and the 9. So let's simplify by doing the distributive property first in the middle. So that gives you 2x minus 10. And now, just like the previous problem, we need to get the x by itself. So first let's add 10 to both sides, and I mean all three parts. So that gives us 9 is less than or equal to 2x is less than 19. And now we can divide everything by 2 so that we see that x is between 9 halves and 19 halves. And this time we have the less than both ways, so we don't have to switch the way we're reading it. And we've got 9 halves is less than or equal, so we're going to have a bracket to show it's equal to 9 halves, and then it goes all the way up to 19 halves without touching. And so there is part B. All right, on to part C. So we've got 3x is greater than 5, or negative x minus 6 is less than 1. So for each of those, let's solve. So for this first one, we're going to divide both sides by 3. So x is greater than 5/3, or now over on this side, we could multiply both sides by negative 1 first to get rid of the negative signs, or we could just add 6 to both sides first. I'm going to do it that way. So you have negative 6 is less than 7. Now here's where you have to be careful. It says negative x is less than 7. We need to know what x equals, or is greater than, or less than. We can divide by negative 1, but when you divide both sides of an inequality by any negative number or multiply by a negative number, you have to switch the inequality sign. So I like to do it like this. I think of this as a negative 1x, and I'm going to divide both sides by negative 1, but that means this is no longer less than 7. It means it's going to be greater. And in fact, it's going to be greater than negative 7. OK? Okay. Now, you should check this to see if it makes sense anytime you have an inequality like this. So if I said x is greater than -7, if I pick a number bigger than -7, it should make this equation true, the original one. So notice I could put 0 in for x. 0 is bigger than -7. And if I plug 0 back up into the original, that gives me -6 is less than 1. It's true. So it looks like I've got that inequality going the correct direction. That's also a good idea to do on the previous problem. But here are the two solutions, but how do we write this using interval notation? Well, we want x is greater than 5/3 and x is also greater than -7. Well, if you think about that on a number line, 5/3 is 1 2/3, and -7 somewhere to the left of that. And we want numbers that are either bigger than -7, right? Okay. Or they could be greater than 5/3. So together, if you put these together, really it's just bigger than -7. Okay? Because it's already, once it's bigger than -7, it's automatically bigger than 1 2/3. So the final answer to this one is just bigger than 7, and an interval bigger than -7. In interval notations, that's -7 to infinity. And that's the answer to this one. Let's go back a second to this problem here. I said you might want to check a number. So remember, 9/2 is 4.5, right? And 19/2 is 9.5. And so what you could do is check that a number in between those really makes the original equation true as a little check. So, pick some number between 4.5 and 9.5. How about, 5? That's an easy number to plug in. So if we go back to the original problem, which was right here. We're going to plug that in. Right. So if we're going to plug in 5, just make sure this equation's still true. It's always a good idea to check. So if you put in 5 for x, so this would be 2 times 0 is less than 9. It's saying -1 is less than or equal to 0, which is less than 9. And yeah, that checks. So it looks like we've got this correct. Okay, but we did part A, B, and C, and that was the answer to C.